Hello dear students, welcome in my YouTube channel Microbiology by Santosh Napte. For more videos on microbiology and other papers of microbiology, don't forget to subscribe my channel so that you will get notifications after uploading videos on this YouTube channel. So in today we will see about the microbial genetics, and in that we are going to study about the genetic material. So in this topic, that is in genetic material, first we will see about evidences for DNA as a genetic material. In that we are going to study this Griffith's experiment. Then we will study about Avery et al. Experiment. Then we will see Hershey and Chase experiment. Then second subtopic in this unit is discovery of RNA as a viral genetic material, and the experiment which we will see here is Gira and Schramm experiment conducted on tobacco mosaic virus. Then next we will see properties of DNA as a genetic material. After that, chemical stability of DNA and its information content. And lastly, we will see structure of prokaryotic chromosomes. In that, we will see E. coli, the model genetic organism. So one by one we are going to see here. First, we will see about deoxyribonucleic acid or DNA as a genetic material. So all of you know that DNA or deoxyribonucleic acid is a genetic material in all living organisms except some viruses. So whatever that living things are present in nature, all these living things, they have deoxyribonucleic acid or DNA as a genetic material. But there are few viruses are there which have RNA as a genetic material. And this DNA, it stores all the necessary information which is required for formation of new individual and to perform all cellular activities or all cellular functions. Initially, it was assumed that proteins which are made up of 20 different types of amino acids, these are responsible for cellular functions or for cellular activities. But many scientists throughout the world, they perform large number of experiments, and they experimentally proved that DNA is genetic material in all living organisms except some viruses in which the genetic material is RNA. And both of these, that is DNA as well as RNA, these are nucleic acids. So we will see here first DNA or deoxyribonucleic acid. That DNA, it is a polynucleotide, that is nothing but it is made up of many nucleotides. Poly means here many, and so that's why that DNA is called as polynucleotide. It is made up of three components. One is pentose sugar, and the pentose sugar which is present in DNA, it is called as deoxyribose. Second component of DNA is nitrogen bases. There are four types of nitrogen bases are present in DNA. One is adenine, second one is thymine, third one is guanine, and fourth one is cytosine. And the third component of DNA molecule is phosphate group, which is derived from phosphoric acid, that is H3PO4. So these are the three different components of DNA molecule. So the next point we will see here, that is nitrogen bases of DNA and RNA. Fundamentally, these nitrogen bases, they are divided into two main types. One is purines and second one is pyrimidines. So four types of purines are present here. One is adenine, or which is also called as 6-aminopurine. Second one is guanine, or which is also called as 2-amino-6-oxypurine. Third one is fibroxanthine, or which is also called as 6-oxypurine. And fourth one is xanthine, which is also called as 2,6-dioxypurine. Actually, these last two purine nitrogen bases, that is hypoxanthine and xanthine, these are not present in nucleic acids or not present in DNA. So these are the four nitrogen bases which are specifically called as purines. Then the second main type of nitrogen bases are known as pyrimidines. There are four types of pyrimidines are there. One is uracil, second one is thymine, third one is cytosine, and the fourth one is orotic acid. Uracil is also called as 2,4-dioxypyrimidine. Thymine is also known as 2,4-dioxy-5-methylpyrimidine. Cytosine is called as 2-oxy-4-aminopyrimidine. And that orotic acid is called as 2,4-dioxy-6-carboxypyrimidine. So this orotic acid, it is not present in nucleic acids. That is, it is not in DNA as well as not present in RNA molecule. But this three remaining pyrimidine bases, that is uracil, thymine and cytosine, they are present in nucleic acids. Uracil, it is actually not present in DNA molecule, but it is present in RNA instead of thymine. See, this is the slide which shows nucleosides. See, these are the purine nitrogen bases, which are actually double ring compounds. So these are the purines. One is adenine, second one is guanine. And these purines, these are double ring compounds and these are numbered here. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, then 7, 8, 9. And second type of purine nitrogen base is guanine. Then another type of nitrogen bases, which are called as pyrimidine. And these pyrimidines are single ring compounds. And this includes, one is cytosine, second one is uracil, and third one is thymine. See, this is the another diagram which shows nucleoside and nucleotides. So when there is a presence of nitrogen base, any of nitrogen base plus this pentose sugar, then it is called as nucleoside. And when there is a third component, that is phosphate, is attached to this nucleoside, then it is called as nucleotide. And if there is a presence of one phosphate group, then it is called as nucleotide monophosphate. If it consists of two phosphate groups, then it is called as nucleotide diphosphate. If it is consists of three phosphate group, then it is called as nucleotide triphosphate. So these are nothing but the nucleotides, that is nucleotide monophosphate, nucleotide diphosphate and nucleotide triphosphate, which consist of one phosphate group, two phosphate groups and three phosphate groups respectively. So the another difference is here in pentose sugar, which is present in nucleic acids. In ribonucleic acid, that pentose sugar, it is called as ribose sugar, where at second carbon atom of this sugar, there is a hydroxyl group is present here. And in DNA molecule, this pentose sugar, it is called as deoxyribose sugar. D means here to remove and oxy means oxygen. So in pentose sugar present in DNA molecule, that oxygen from second carbon atom is removed. So that's why it is called as deoxyribose sugar. And Just see here the bond which is present between pentose sugar, that is for example in case of DNA deoxyribose sugar, and any nitrogen base, that bond is called as glycosidic bond. So the bond which is present in or between this nitrogen base and sugar, that is the glycosidic bond. So this is about the nucleosides present in DNA molecule. And we have also seen that here that purines, these are double ring compounds, and that pyrimidines, these are single ring compounds. So the next slide is again that is of nucleoside and nucleotide. As I told earlier here that any nitrogen base plus pentose sugar, that is called as nucleoside, and if that nitrogen base is adenine, then it is known as adenosine. If that nitrogen base is guanine, then that nucleoside is called as guanosine. If that nitrogen base is thymine, then that nucleoside is called as thymidine. So like that. And when phosphate group is attached to this nucleoside, then it is called as nucleotide. There is a single phosphate group used here, that's why it is known as adenosine monophosphate. If two phosphate groups are there, then it is called as adenosine diphosphate. And if there are three phosphate groups are there, then this is called as adenosine triphosphate. So this is the diagram of nucleoside and nucleotide. See, the next diagram is of again nucleoside, but here all nitrogen bases are present. See, this is the nucleosides which are the derivatives of purines and pyrimidines, and they have a sugar linked to a ring nitrogen. So here adenosine, in which that carbon 1 of this pentose sugar, it is attached to the nitrogen 9 of that adenine nitrogen base. So the nucleoside consisting of this adenine, it is called as adenosine. Then second one is cytidine, that is nothing but that sugar plus that nitrogen base here, but the bonding is between carbon 1 of pentose sugar and nitrogen 1 of nitrogen base. Then this is the third nucleoside, that is guanosine, and this is fourth one, that is called as uridine, which is present in RNA molecule. So here the sugar is linked to the heterocyclic base via beta N glycosidic bond, and which is almost or always present between N1 of pyrimidine or to N9 of purine. So this is about the nucleosides. So these are the nucleotides present in DNA molecule, that is deoxyadenosine triphosphate, then deoxyguanosine triphosphate, then next one deoxythymidine triphosphate, and deoxycytidine triphosphate. See, this is the pentose sugar, these are three phosphate groups here, and these are the nitrogen bases. Here also same, the nitrogen base is guanine, then pentose sugar, and three phosphate groups. Here the nitrogen base is thymine, this is pentose sugar, and these are the three phosphate groups. And in last one, the nitrogen base is here cytosine, this is pentose sugar, and these are the phosphate groups. So these are the nucleotides present in DNA molecules. So this is the next slide, which shows structure of nucleosides and nucleotides. So in this diagram, see, this is the pentose sugar, and here it is a double ring nitrogen base, that is purine. This bond which is present between the carbon 1, that is first prime, and nitrogen 9 of this purine base, it is called as N-beta glycosidic bond or linkage. And this is present between carbon 1 of sugar and nitrogen 9 of nitrogen base if it is purine. Then that bond which is present between carbon 1 sugar and nitrogen 1 of nitrogen base, that is pyrimidine. So that bond is called as N beta glycosidic linkage. This one, this bond is called as glycosidic linkage, and here this is the purine nitrogen base, which is a double ring compound, and so that's why it is present between the carbon 1 of sugar and nitrogen 9 of that nitrogen base. Then, so here there is a presence of only nitrogen base and pentose sugar. For example, this is the ribose sugar, so that's why it is called as nucleoside. So this is known as nucleoside, and this one, it is called as nucleotide, in which there is a nitrogen base is present, plus there is a that pentose sugar is present here, and plus there is a phosphate groups are present. So these three compounds, when they are present, then collectively it is called as nucleotide. So again here, this is the N beta glycosidic linkage, like which is present in this nucleoside also, and here this is the phosphodiester bond, that is 1, 2 or 3 phosphate groups, and at the end of 3 prime or to the 5 prime hydroxyl groups. So this is about the nucleosides and nucleotides, and in next diagram we will see the general structure of this DNA molecule. So all of you know that this DNA molecule, it is a double helical structure which consists of 2 strands, and on each strand there is a nucleotides are present, and they are paired with each other from both strands. So this is called as the base pairing, and there is also presence of, so what are this base pairing is here, so it is present. For example, adenine always pairs with thymine by 2 hydrogen bonds. See here, this is the adenine nitrogen base here, and this is thymine. Now they are bonded with each other by 2 hydrogen bonds. Then cytosine always pairs with guanine by 3 hydrogen bonds, 1, 2 and 3. Then thymine pairs with adenine again by 2 hydrogen bonds, and then guanine pairs with cytosine by 3 hydrogen bonds. Whatever that 2 strands of that DNA molecules are there, these are anti-parallel in nature. For example, if the one end of this strand is 5 prime, then the another one will be 3 prime end. This 3 prime, it is actually the end of this strand of DNA molecule, and this 5 prime, this is the another end of this DNA strand. Here also, this 3 prime means this end of this DNA strand is here, and this 5 prime end means here, this one. So both of these strands, they are anti-parallel in nature. So in this way, and here these are the base pairing, then this is called as the major groove, then this is known as minor groove, and this is called as sugar phosphate backbone. And the bond which is present between nucleotides on the same strand, that bond is called as phosphodiester bond, or it is known as phosphodiester linkage. So this is called as phosphodiester linkage, which connects these 2 nucleotides from the same strand. This one, or this is also the phosphodiester linkage, this is also the phosphodiester linkage, or here also. So these are the phosphodiester linkage which connects that nucleotides present on the same strand. So this is about the simple structure or general structure of this DNA molecule in brief. And in next slide, we will see the difference between DNA and RNA. So this is DNA and here RNA molecule. So all of you know that DNA stands for deoxyribonucleic acid, and the sugar portion of DNA molecule is called as 2 deoxyribose. Then this is RNA, that stands for ribonucleic acid, and the sugar portion in RNA, it is called as ribose. Then DNA is double stranded molecule consisting of long chain of nucleotides, and RNA, it is a single stranded molecule which consists of shorter chain of nucleotides. Next difference is the bases present in DNA molecule are adenine, guanine, cytosine and thymine, and the nitrogen bases which are present in RNA, these are called as adenine, guanine, cytosine and uracil. See here, uracil, it is not present in DNA, and instead of uracil there is thymine is there, and in RNA it is uracil. Then DNA is self-replicating, then RNA is synthesized from DNA on a as per requirement or need. Then base pairing in DNA molecule is adenine pairs with thymine or vice versa, or guanine pairs with cytosine or vice versa. Two hydrogen bonds are present between adenine and thymine, or thymine and adenine, and that three hydrogen bonds are present between guanine and cytosine or vice versa. And the base pairing in RNA is adenine uracil or guanine cytosine, but when there is a folding of that RNA molecule takes place. Then the next difference is purine and pyrimidine bases are equal in number. That is nothing but whatever the number of purine bases are there in DNA molecule, the same will be the pyrimidine bases. That is known as Chargaff's rule, A plus T equal to G plus C. So, and there is no proportionality in between the number of purine and pyrimidine bases in RNA molecule. Then DNA is susceptible to ultraviolet damage, which results into the formation of thymine-thymine dimer when that DNA molecule is exposed to ultraviolet light. And as compared to DNA molecule, this RNA is relatively resistant to the ultraviolet damage. Next difference is hydrogen bonds which are formed between complementary nitrogen bases of the opposite strands, that is adenine-thymine and cytosine-guanine or vice versa. So this base pairing through hydrogen bonds occurs when that RNA molecule get folded, otherwise it is single-stranded. Then DNA is found in the nucleus of all cell and in mitochondria also. And in case of RNA, depending on the type of RNA molecule, this molecule is present in cell's nucleus, its cytoplasm, as well as in ribosomes. Then next one, DNA can't leave the nucleus, but RNA, it can leave the nucleus in the form of mRNA molecule or messenger RNA molecule. Next one, the carbon hydrogen bonds in DNA make it fairly stable. Plus, the body destroys enzymes that would attack DNA molecule. And the small grooves in the helix, they act as a protection, providing minimal space for enzymes to attach. In case of RNA, the oxygen-hydrogen bond in ribose of this molecule makes the molecule more reactive as compared to DNA molecule. And RNA is not stable under alkaline condition. Plus, the larger grooves in the molecule makes it more susceptible to enzyme attack. Then DNA is only two types, that is intranuclear and extranuclear. And there are three different types of RNAs are there. One is messenger RNA, second one is transfer RNA, and third one is ribosomal RNA. And the functions of DNA are long-term storage of genetic information, then transmission of genetic information from one generation to next generation, and make the other cells and new organisms. And the functions of RNAs are, these are used to transfer the genetic code from the nucleus to the ribosomes to form or to make proteins. Then these RNAs is used to transmit genetic information in some organisms and may have molecules used to store genetic blueprints in primitive organisms. So all these about the basics of that DNA molecule, nitrogen bases, then we have seen about structure of that nitrogen bases, types of nitrogen bases, then we have seen a brief structure of that DNA molecule, and in next lecture we will start with evidences for DNA as a genetic material. So watch this full video, like, dislike, comment, share, and don't forget to subscribe this channel. Thank you.